All right, everybody, I think, yeah, okay. Today we're going to try something a little different for today's mailbag. Hang on just a minute. Get this set up first. Let's turn this off, it's noisy. Okay, let me see how that looks. Yeah. Guess it's working. Well, we could use some more light over there. Oh, hey, let's turn on the lights. Okay. So, here we go. I definitely want to pick up an orange boy before we get started. But first, let's do this. The thing we're going to do that's new is I got a different microphone to use that might sound a little better. It might actually sound too good. I don't know. A little maybe too intimate. We'll see, because it's not what we're used to. So I'm going to switch it on right now, and we're going to have to see together whether it's like too loud or too weird or what it might be. Hang on. Okay, well, apparently that didn't work. Let me just check one thing real quick, and then we'll skip it for today and keep rolling if it doesn't work. So hang on one more second. Okay, testing. Okay, and hang on now. Okay. All right. Well, in that case, let me take this off. I'll be right back and then we'll get started. Alright, it was worth a shot. Next time, I guess. Hang on. Alright, I'm pretty sure I know what's not working there, so we'll have it set for next time. Meanwhile, we'll just have to suffer through with the same bad audio we've had for a long time now. Just trying to make little incremental improvements. Now, let me double check, make sure everything is working this time. Good. That looks good. All right, looks good to me. I guess you guys will have to let me know if it's not good. But I think we're okay for now. Like I said, we'll get that networking next time then. I didn't have much time before. I tried to get it hooked up like 10 minutes ago, and I guess I should have given myself more time to check it out. So next time. All right. Meanwhile, the big news this week, of course, is that we've got new kittens. Our mom cat had her babies. The mom cat's name is Puddles, and the kittens all have names I have not learned yet, but let me read them to you real quick. You're right, I did forget to get Teaspoon. I'll grab Teaspoon, but first the names. I'm not going to try to describe which one is which because we're not up there. We'll get it on a close-up. But in birth order, they are named Raindrop, Bud, Brawly, Sprout, and Drizzle. So there you have it. Let me grab an orange kitten and... Oh, there you are, buddy. Hi, you want to come hang out for a bit, buddy? Hey, pal, come with me. Hi, Maggie, that's my seat, though. Can I sit here? Come on. Okay. All right, so there you have it. New names, new kittens. Everything else is pretty much the same as it has been. No other news to report. Kittens are all doing fine, healthy, they're growing. Our little orange boy here had his visit to the vet where we found out that he does have a little bit of a heart problem, but it's not the enlarged heart that we thought. That's more of a symptom than the cause. And it seems like the cause is that he's got a constricted pathway in his heart that makes it a little harder to pump stuff through. It's very rare, but it may be something that he can just grow out of. So right now, we're hoping that's what happens, but we're going to keep an eye on it, of course. And if he doesn't grow out of it, we're prepared to do something about that when the time is right. So we'll see. Okay, now let's see here. Good. I think we're going. Okay, good. So now let's... see here. Okay to read on stream, sealed with a loving paw print. Excellent. It says, oh, have a cracking Easter. DJ, this just reminded me, DJ and I have been watching a lot of Antiques Roadshow on BritBox, the British streaming service from the BBC. And we were just watching, there was this like a pendant that this lady was describing last night, and she says, this is a cracking pendant. And then the very next thing she said is how great it was that it wasn't cracked. I'm like, that can only make sense if you're British. Anyway, all right, have a cracking Easter. And it's got actually the same kind of pun being made here in that there's actually a cracked egg on the front that's not very happy about it. And inside it says, okay to read on stream. Hello, Mr. A, DJ, and all the furries. Just a wee card to wish you a happy Easter and a lovely springtime. It's always a privilege to watch Kitten Academy. The good it does for kitties and humans is incalculable. Quite simply, KA makes the world a better place with lots of love and the very best wishes from Joanne, your greatest Scottish fan. Well, thank you so much, Joanne. That is really sweet of you to say, and happy Easter to you as well. I'd like to say, great Scott. I don't know why. It just sounds like an exclamation that's... I wish I could do it like... what's the name of the actor from Back to the Future? He's got a great way of saying it, but I'm not good at imitations, so I'm not going to try it. Okay, let's see. Wow, we've got some really cute. Oh, these are postcards of various kittens, and it looks like they each say something on them. So let's see here. We've got three different postcards all put together in an envelope. Cute, and it was sealed with some holographic stickers of kitties and mice. And inside the postcards, wow, these are really pretty. This one says, Dear Mr. A and Dr. DJ, thank you for all you do. It's so amazing to see the love and care given to all the cats. Also, from the Discord KA community, a family caring for cats and each other. Makes me hopeful and comforted in this crazy world. Give Nibbles and the kids a big spoogle from me, Norway cat fan. Well, thank you. I know the feeling. The people that I have, all of you people doesn't sound like a good phrase. All of the people, the wonderful folks on the Discord, they really do give me the hope for humanity that otherwise feels like it would have been robbed at this point. There's two more. Dear DJ and Mr. A, it's so comforting to see the Q-tensils growing up. I just started working more hours, and it's so great to come home tired and just watching Rammy, Spatula, Spork, and Goblet playing with Little Teaspoon. Thank you again. Purrs and hugs from Norway Cat Fan. Great choice of postcards. Let's see here. And then finally, hi, Mr. A and DJ. I love seeing the faculty on the live stream too. Custard is a big soft kitten. Maggie, Queen Floof Mom Cat. Brother Ari, the sleek gentleman, please pet. Logan, Liquor of Kitties. And Eddie, Green Eyed Shetty. I'm so glad they are in my life. Hugs and purrs from Norway Cat Fan. Well, thank you, Norway Cat Fan. We're so glad you are in our life. Very cute little postcards that you've sent. Super glossy, too. Those are very nice. Thank you for the kind words. Oh, okay, buddy, you can go. You can go, okay? I'm not going to keep you here because maybe you got to go poop or something, but you get one more snuggle and a little belly scratch. This guy loves to have his belly scratched when he's in the mood to hang out. If I start petting his back, he gets into it. You can see he's always got the elevator butt. And then if it's the right time, he'll start purring, and then he flops over and rolls onto his belly so I can scratch his belly, and he just purrs. He'll do that here we go. He'll do that just indefinitely. Oh, not too sure about it, actually. Okay, maybe it's not the time. Maybe you do have to go somewhere and use the litter box or what? Because there's no purr happening, but boy, does he like it. All right. So, thank you so much. One more time, Norway Cat Fan. That's it for our letters. We've got some boxes and stuff to go through, though. So let's get rolling on that. Okay, Kitten Academy. Okay, maybe there's a note on the inside. Let's find out. Perhaps. Fingers. There we go. There is something on the inside. With so much going on at the Kitten Academy, I figured you might enjoy a helping paw with this to-do list. Thank you for all you do. Writer 12 on Discord and family. Oh, hello today. This is a really cute little to-do list. It's a daily today to-do list. It's got little cats to represent the three different types. We've got the one that is, I seriously need to get these things done for real. The second section is, and these would be nice too, but hey, life will go on. And the third section is, and if a miracle happens, so will these. And then there's also some excellent check marks at the bottom. Did you exercise? Are you hydrated? And did you take deep breaths? At the top, there's a space for the date, the word for today, and maybe I'll treat myself too. That is so sweet. What a great idea. And I love the encouragement to stay hydrated and exercised. That's something that I really, really need to focus on. Both of those things actually have become super important to me, and I'm not keeping up with either one of them properly. They're surprisingly difficult. Everybody understands how difficult it is to start working out, but it's almost equally difficult to stay hydrated properly. So it's great. There's a little reminder for that here. This is really, really cute. Hello today. So thank you for that so much. That's pretty great. I really appreciate it. Okay, next up, let's see, whatever's just sitting. Oh, it's jingly. Let's see what it could be. Tear here to open. Will this work for me? Oh, looks like it did. Moving. Oh wow. Okay, I see. This is a ball track. Hang on, there's probably a note. It's a ball track with a wand toy, a spinning wand toy that attaches to the top, so you can leave it in there, and it can be a little toy for them to play with. You can see there's a little ball track at the bottom. The wand can come out and spin around, or you can leave it in there and it can spin around. Pretty cool idea. Happy Catterday to Mr. A, DJ Cats, Kitten Discorders, and YouTubers. The carrot toy is a little addition to last time's carrot bed and is for all KA kittens. Okay. Well, this is describing things that aren't in here at all, unless this could be a carrot, I suppose, with a little imagination. So maybe we'll say that, but I don't know. I think there could be something else, because then you go on to say other things that aren't also in this package. So we'll have to keep an eye out for them. You say the catnip pineapple is for Puddles, because I know she would love it. From Madam Amy Lotta. Well, thank you so much, Madam Amy Lotta. Wow. With my little throat going here, it's probably just as well that that lav mic didn't work. I'd probably be hearing a little too much of that gravelly voice today. So, anyway, this looks really fun. Thank you so much for that. And we'll keep an eye out for the catnip pineapple for Puddles and maybe a carrot toy, or maybe this is the carrot toy. It really does look carroty. So, I guess we'll find out. Meanwhile, let's grab whatever's next here. To Kitten Academy from Hell's Dells. All right, Hell's Dells. Let's find out what we've got in store for us. Ooh. Okay, well, we'll find the note in here eventually, but let's just start. These have some notes here. Please save one for the next class. I think the tinies would like them. And they are, oh, rocket ships and, wow, what kind of rocket ship thing is this, though? Can't even tell what it is. Oh, look at that. Oh, I see. We've got a carrot. Well, that's perfect for now. And the rocket ship may be for the next class. And the carrot, wow, that's pretty inventive. It's got a crinkly bit. It's got these little balls on the end that have, yes, they are elastic, so you can pull on them. It's got a big ring in the middle. And the ring actually has bunny ears on it, which is weird, and a tie. So if you hold it this way, it's kind of a bunny. And if you hold it this way, it's kind of a carrot. That's unusual, though. Takes a little bit of imagination. Or maybe you just flip it this way, I see is a carrot, this way is a bunny. I don't know. It's pretty abstract regardless. This is the carrot from the Hungry Hungry Caterpillar, apparently. Anyway, very cute. And then we have a similar, oh, we have a rocket. It's not a rocket, it's a rocket, which is perfect. It'll go great. I'll wear it with my Rolex watch. It's very cute though. I love the rocket. I love the little porthole in it that you can see all the way through. So it's hard to say which one to deploy, but since Easter is here, I'm going to leave this carrot right here for the kids to find and play with. And the rocket we will save for the next class, perhaps. It smells very catnippy in the bag too, so maybe they've got a little bit of the catnip in them, which would be ideal. All right, let me set this back here. We're still digging. Well, eventually, there may be a note to find in here. There it is. I see it. Hang on. This says Nibbles and the kids, but here's the note. The note says, "Hi, Chris, DJ, cats, and kitties. I have put some labels on a few things. Everything else is as you see fit. And some Easter treats for you. Love, Hell's Dells." Hell's Dells, thank you so much. Maggie's opening this one. What are you smelling there, Maggie? It's not for you though. This one is for Nibbles and the kids. Hi. Okay. Wow. You're very interested. Why? Could it be because there's a catnip banana in it? This is that weird catnip banana that has the peel halfway off. It's also from Yao, the ones that make the catnip banana that we're all so familiar with. But this is the second time I've seen one that has a peel on it, which is unusual, and I like it. And okay, well, it is to go in this room, I guess. But technically, it's for Nibbles behind you, Maggie. That's okay. I haven't seen Nibbles really go for the catnip yet, so maybe Maggie can have first go at it. I would just hand it off to her right now, but I don't want there to be a little bit of a struggle between them, so we'll just let Maggie have it. Meanwhile, we also have Yaola crayons. That's interesting. Anyway, the set of three crayons, perfect for the little kittens. And we have a catnip smitten kitten, it says. Oh, very interesting. It's a Freak Me Out brand, purveyors of superior Canadian catnip toys, handmade in Wales. Now, that's weird because I did not previously think Wales was part of Canada. But there you have it. Purveyors of superior Canadian catnip toys handmade in Wales. So, I mean, who am I to argue? It's very cute, though. It's like a little burlap sack with really cute little hearts on it. And obviously, it must be very catnippy. I'm not going to open it yet. Then we also have from the same brand, Freak Me Out Catnip Lucille the Cat, handmade in Wales also. It says, not on the highstreet.com/freakmeout. That's Freak, M-E-O-W-T, of course. And I don't know how well you can see the cute little embroidery here. This must be the same one that made the little Prince cat and the Prince cat's around here somewhere. That's Prince the musician. And then there's also a David Bowie one somewhere around. And I don't know exactly where it's gone, but they look the same. I think it must be the same kind of brand. Okie dokie. Because I think you were the one that sent those, right? Here we have lettuce. Okay. We have, oh, this is one of those silver vine, geometrical shapes that DJ has given to the cats before that they all like quite a bit. Maggie's a fan of them, too. She wants to check it out. I don't know, Maggie, do you have to sample every toy, or can you let somebody else have some fun? We have a little loose felted catnip fish. These wands. These are the great wands that we like to use at the bedside. They're wonderful to play with the little kittens, and they've got an end that is real fur. The kittens love these. They're great little first starter toys. We have a strawberry, apparently, some kind of a strawberry or something. Hell says, let Maggie have the banana. I think she's already moved on, but we'll see. It'll be out here, and she can have it if she wants. Here we have a piece of real fur, with a whistle in it, and a string that I guess would be to hang from a doorknob or something. Hi, Maggie, you want to play with everything. Look, that matches you perfectly. It's the exact same color. It's gray and white. It matches her exactly. Look at that. You could just put that on her and you'd never even know it was there. Huh. And it's got one of those little whistles in it. DJ is so amused by those. I'm so amused by them too. I shouldn't just pin that on DJ. I had a lot of them when I was a kid, though. They'd come in the can and they'd make like a moo sound or something. This is a piece of weird little red fur on a ribbon. And there's not too much else to it. This is obviously something. Maggie's just in a play mood right now. She wants to play with everything. And that's okay with me. We will have to put that ribbon away, though, later on. Here's another one of the fur sticks, I guess, is what we'll call that. Fantastic little toys for the kittens. This says chocolate. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, wow. Looks like various types. Oh, wow, a tube of mini eggs. I have not seen them in this packaging before. That's pretty fun. Also, a bag of, after 8 mini eggs. That's those fancy mints. That's going to be fun. And something else, some loose lint bugs. We've got bees and ladybugs made of lint chocolate, apparently. Look how cute those are. Well, those will be super fun. For now, I'm going to set those, I guess, right over here. And then as we start to gather stuff that's for me and DJ, we can put it in a box or something. All right. Thank you so much for that. But there's still more to go through here. There we go. Lots more in here. Okay, we got another one of these weird little geometrical things. We've got another, this is a cactus, I guess. Oh, this one might be some kind of that's a strawberry. It's a pink strawberry. We're going to go with that. Not quite right yet. Nibbles and the Kids, different styles. All right, let's see what that means. Oh, it's a whole bunch of real fur toys, and they are all different styles. My goodness. This one has cloth on one side with a neat thing, and then this pattern on the other side, black and white on the other side. I guess there's probably some catnip in there. We have what looks like a Rosie the Rat. It's not quite Rosie the Rat, but it's got a little leather tail on it. We have, another one of the pillows. There we go. Maggie's working on that. She's got the banana and the ribbon both at the same time. Okay, we've got some more here with the little leather tails. So fun. Oh, wow, a big one. And one more, this one with more of a little fur tail. Those are great catnip toys. I think the triangle shaped ones actually was a request from one of the previous adopters that got one of those from you. And then their kitty loved it so much they wanted to get another one, right? Who was that though? I forget. I remember that happening, but now I don't remember which kitten it was. Anyway, these are perfect. Thank you so much. Nibbles and her kids are gonna love it. Those fur toys just are, the kittens love those so much. Here we have another one labeled for Nibbles and the kids. And this includes, oh wow, okay, some little British balls, I suppose. Oh, this is the all British set, I guess. We've got a bag of who knows what. It's exploding with Britishness, though. Britishosity, yeah, something like that. So we got two of those bags and four of the little catnip balls for them to play with. That's super cute. They're gonna love it. There we go. Good, good. It's good for them to have a little knowledge of the world, more than I have anyway. Oh, another chocolate. What is this? Let's find out. Oh, wow. I think this is, no, it's different. Look at that. It's called Nibbles. It says caramel nibbles inside the egg. So I'm guessing it's a chocolate egg and then it's filled with other chocolate caramels. Little cho Oh, there's a cutaway view right there. So they have little chocolate caramels inside a giant chocolate egg, and they're apparently called caramel nibbles. How perfect is that? I guess that's why you sent them, and they're Easter too. It all comes together. Oh my goodness. Here we have a mackerel fillet encore treat. That looks so good. It's got the shiny skin still on it, and these little fillets are a big hit. And I'll tell you something about Nibbles. Really has earned her name lately. She has become a food fiend. And she's not like some mom cats that will like get in your plate no matter what you do, but she begs and begs and begs, and then if you let her have something, then she turns it on and starts to sort of try to get in your plate. But the funny thing is she gets so desperate for the food that she wants. It doesn't matter what it is, it must be good. So she makes no distinction about whether it's something a cat should like. You could be eating a tomato or an apple, and she still is like, I need to have some of whatever it is. And she gets so like sort of frustrated and desperate that if she gets half a second to get into it, and she sees you like going to take her away from it, so like she'll be sneaking up on a bowl that I've left unattended, and then she sees me coming for it, and she's like, oh, this is my only chance, and she'll jump in there and grab whatever she can, and then she tries to eat it. And I've seen her, she grabbed a lime out of my food the other day. Maggie, you don't need to be directly in front of the camera, especially not doing that. Sit over here. Okay, here, take your catnip banana, sit off on the side. So yeah, the other day she grabbed a lime out of my bowl that way and tried to eat the lime. She took like two chomps of it before she was like, maybe this isn't for me after all. And then last night I was eating a green curry and it had these big chunks, I mean giant chunks of green pepper in it, a bell pepper. And she grabbed one of those the same way where I was starting to sort of take her away from the bowl and she's like, I'll just grab whatever I can get. It was a green pepper, and she, when I went to take it from her, I'm like, you don't want to eat that, let me have it. She swallowed it whole. She's like, no, I am eating this. And just swallowed the whole thing in one giant gulp. It was pretty silly, actually. So she's a real foodie, Nibbles is. Okie dokie. Let's see. Next up, 4KA rainbow theme. Oh, and it is perfect. That's heavy too. I guess it is it's like a beanbaggy toy kind of thing. And it is a cute little rainbow. Look, it's got little paws and it's got a smiley face and it is a rainbow. That's adorable. I especially love the little paws it's got. That's super cute. That will go great with all of our the theme that we've got that is rainbows and unicorns. There's lots of rainbows and unicorns. I've got all that set aside downstairs. That is a perfect addition to that. I don't know where to put it right now. We'll sort all this out afterwards. For the faculty or around the house. Okay, this is the last one. Oh, Custard's got to try the banana too. Good job, buddy. Oh, wow. This is beautiful. This is another piece of real fur here that's just lovely. And on the back, we have rainbows and clouds. That's so cute. Oh, I love the print. It's really beautiful. It's a big kicker. I bet Custard is going to love it. He loves the big kickers. This is one of his favorite toys to play with this real fur. Oh, it's starting to come apart at the seams. Wow. I don't know if you can see that, but he loves playing with this thing. So I wonder if he would go. Oh, he's got the banana right Okay, well, you can play with the banana and we'll save this for you, okay, pal? Awesome. Telltales, that is such a generous set of wonderful cat toys. Thank you so much for sending those. And thank you for the chocolates, which I am going to love, even though I probably shouldn't. I am going to. So thank you very much for all of that. Okay. Let's see. We need to open a box so we have a place to put things. Which box looks like it might provide that? I don't think any of them will, actually. That's fine, though. Let's open one anyhow. This one's covered in Easter stickers on the top, and it says Carrot Palooza. So it must be from Carrot Palooza on Discord. Guard, not as ugly as my last one, but it's still pretty sad, but not as sad as my handwriting skills on the enclosed card. Wow, that's a knife guard. I don't, your handwriting here anyway is fantastic, so we'll see about the card. And Carrot Palooza, it looks like this includes a new fresh Carrot Palooza. I can see there's a giant stack of Easter carrots in here. This is just three of them, but there are more. Oh, look at that, they're labeled. Some of them are labeled. This one's had the label fallen off, I think. Yes, that's why I didn't tell at first. But this one, oh, it says Spork, and it's got a little felt carrot here right next to it, Spork. And this one says, with much love from the Carrot Palooza gang, and I guess they must all say that on the back, it says Ramekin, also with a little felted carrot. Those are super cute. Then we have one also for Spatula, and... teaspoon and Nibbles. That's perfect. And then the label that fell off is right here. And that makes the last one for Goblet. That makes too much sense. All right, we'll keep all those together and then we can find the label at the right time. For now, let me set those back here. All right, out of the way. There's a note here. It says the Kitten Academy family. And it's got a little rabbit, I guess, holding a carrot and another carrot over here. Ooh, and the card itself is a carrot. This is a Carrot Palooza from Carrot Palooza. Look at that. It's all made out of embroidered felt, and it's got little little gemstones for eyes. So cute. All right, and inside the rabbit, no, inside the rabbit. What behind the rabbit? Let's see here. Wishing you happy little surprises this Easter. The Carrot Palooza gang, Robin, Thomas, Max, Lily, Trixie, and Minx. Happy Easter, K.A. Enclosed, oh, you say you can't write in this carrot, but I can read this just fine. It says, enclosed are the utensils, carrots for their endowments, and a blankie for use as you see fit. Maybe for tea or Nibbles endowments, and some carrot-themed goodies for K.A. Well, thank you, and the card is really cute. I'm going to put that over here. So, carrot-themed goodies. Oh, look at that. We have a rabbit basket. Perfect for Easter. There we go. Very cute little basket. And inside the basket, we have... Ooh, carrot candy, apparently. Lint, gold bunny, and friends. So, it's apparently got a bunny in here. And it's also got a little lamb and a chick, a little tiny chick. It's got one of those bee candies that we just saw, and there's a couple truffles too, apparently. How cute is that? And it's shaped like a carrot. That's the cutest little packaging, even with the greens on top. All right, here we have chocolate carrots, and that's exactly what it is, lint, and they are little chocolate carrots, a row of chocolate carrots. You can see that. That's also adorable. And another carrot, ooh, Reese's Pieces. Reese's Pieces carrot, and it is also shaped like a carrot. Okay, you don't need that at all, Maggie. No, you don't need that carrot. No, you don't. That's a carrot for me. Cool, I'm gonna put all the chocolate in this bag then, along with your little note, because that's cute too. Perfection. That's super cute. I like Reese's Pieces quite a bit, and I shouldn't say I don't get to have them very often. I could probably have them as much as I wanted, and any is probably too much. But I am a fan, and DJ hates peanut butter. Or so she says. You know, she likes, like, Thai food that's basically got peanut butter in it. Some of those stuff are really sweet with peanuts. I don't know what the difference is. She doesn't, turns her nose up at anything peanut butter, so those are all mine. This is a cute Easter blanket, just like you said. It's got little bunnies and little carrots on it, and it's very soft, and it's perfect for us to put out somewhere, I think, for Easter, and then maybe to go home with somebody for an endowment. That would be perfect. Or to get packed away for next Easter, who knows? Very, very adorable, though. Given that this is stuff for us, I guess I'll put this box here, make this the stuff for us box for now. We can keep the chocolates out, that works out, and then put this over here, and then we can toss all of these things in there, more or less, I suppose. Those should be random endowments, I think. These are things that need to get used somewhere in particular. This ribbon can't stay out on its own, so that will go in my pocket for now. We can play with the kittens with it. There we go. Good. All right, just getting a little sorted there. Sorted, not sorted. Those are different words. Okie dokie. Now we still need a box to put all these wonderful endowments into. So I don't know what to do. We're just going to keep rolling. This is such a cute box. It's covered in rainbows and unicorns. It's a perfect little box for me. I love it. I thought there might be something written on there that was interesting, but it's not. This is, though. It says, open this end, I think. Great. Well, that's the kind of confidence that I can get behind. So let's open that end, I think. Perhaps. Here we go. There is a little flap that opens on this end, if I can get it to work for me. Oh, that must be DJ's water kettle, the tea kettle that just beeped. Okay, the note, and this is so cute. It's got a drawing of little kittens on it. It says, okay to read on stream, and the kittens are all wearing little rabbit ears. In fact, it looks like the kittens may be the faculty because we have, we have Ari, Maggie, I guess maybe not, Logan, either one of these could be Eddie. There are five of them, though. Very interesting. But the custard one, I don't know. He doesn't look especially like custard. I guess he could be. Sure, why not? It works. They're very cute, though, either way. On the back, we have a kitten who's wearing a beret. And here we go. Open that up carefully because it's got such a beautiful drawing on it. Inside it says, glad Pasch. I don't know what that means at all, and I'm sure I'm mispronouncing it in as far as it goes. There we go. I'll show it to you so you can try it too. Inside there are what appears to be two notes. Let's find out what the other note is. Oh, the list of contents. Okay. This says, hello, Mr. A, Dr. DJ, faculty, and friends. Happy spring. Apologies in advance for the amount of treats included in the box. I really did try to have some self-control. Also, speaking of the box, the second I saw it, I knew it needed to make its way to KA. Well, you're not wrong about that. I'm very much looking forward to attending KAcon this summer. That's right. Jamestown is coming to KAcon. I did not know. That is the coolest thing. I'm super excited to meet everyone, participate in the games, and hang out with the other cat-loving introverts. Which doesn't make much sense, does it? Anyway, I've included a list of what's in the box with translations. Jamestown, PS, craft forever. That's so cute. Wow, I'm so happy that we'll get to meet you in person at KAcon after all this time. That's going to be super fun. All right, the list of contents, distribute as you see fit. All right, well, let's find out what's in here and why any of it needed translations. This one does. This says mini chocolate flarn. Chocolate flarn. Okay. I don't know what that means, but it's fun to say, even if I'm saying it wrong. Apparently, they're little orange chocolate cookies of some kind. Dark chocolate dipped orange oat cookies. I like every part of that. That sounds amazing. You say 2X. I feel cheated. Oh, there it is. Okay. Thank goodness. Those sound so yummy. All right. So we've got two of those. I think our little basket of goodies is going to fill up too fast now. Thought we could fit everything in there, but maybe not. Okay, orange flavored milk chocolate crisps. Well, all the rest is in this gift bag. Oh, and it's right on top. Look at that, in order. That's helpful. Orange flavored milk chocolate crisps. Yes, that's exactly what it is. I've had these before, and so I know they're wonderful. Okay, try to fit that in the basket. All right, now we're going out of order. Sour gummies. You enjoyed these last time. Oh, great. Well, I'm sure I did, and that's exactly what they are. They're little sour gummies. I don't know what they're supposed to be shaped like. Maybe Binkies. I think they're supposed to be little baby Binkies, or whatever you call it, pacifiers. So that I do enjoy sour gummies quite a bit. We have meaty duck and meaty fish, dried duck and dried fish, apparently. What do you say? Duck, cod, salmon, chicken, cat treats, Dogman brand cat treats, grain free. Yeah, all right, awesome. So there we go. I'm going to set those right there in front of Maggie and hope she doesn't try to open them. We have the Ritter Sport Salted Caramel. Do you want me to open one of these, Maggie? I know you love these things, but you're just going to ignore it. She wants to check everything out, and the minute she does, she's done with it, right? You're going to do the same thing here, aren't you? We'll find out. Okay, so we have the Salted Caramel Ritter Sport. These are excellent candy bars. Put that right in there. We have Walker's Shortbread for Dr. DJ. Fantastic. That's some good stuff, too. We have Dreamies. I can guess who this is for. Does it say anywhere? Cheese Dreamies. Oh, are these cheese? No, these are catnip. But that's okay. I was just looking. Oh, one catnip Dreamies. Okay, there it is. Catnip Dreamies. Perfect. Oh, I'm in the wrong box. Okay. What else? What else indeed? Wow, this is really packed through. Assorted cat toys and hex bugs. All right. Let's see. And then, oh, these are so cute. Okay. This is that wire toy that Eddie loves. Perfect. Oh, wow. This is a Silvervine stick with a feather on it, which is a big hit, but it's also got, this one's a little different. It's got like a whole bundle of Silvervine sticks at the end. I don't know if you can see that. It reminds me of those little worms that build their own little cocoon as they travel along. They pick up bits of everything. We used to get them all the time in Illinois. I haven't thought about those for a long time. They're the cutest little things. They're like these little weird worms that turn into moths eventually. But as they travel along the ground, they pick up little bits of whatever they find and form them into a little bag that they then drag along with them and hide in when they need to hide. And it's usually little bits of stones and sticks and we found them several times then with bits of cat hair woven in and all kinds of stuff. Very cute. I haven't thought about those guys in a while. Here we have a bear of some kind with some card. Oh, beaver, I see from the tail. You can see that too. Very cute. And what is this? A rabbit? No, maybe another beaver. I don't know. Or a rabbit. I think it really says rabbit to me, but and then it's got the same tail. So now I'm super confused. Who knows? But they look like good cat toys. Oh, and another one. This one that says walrus in the face. They've all got the same tail, so we're just going to go by the faces. That one's a walrus. What else? Oh my goodness, this is packed in here. How did you get all this stuff into one box? One tiny little unicorn box. Oh, you said hex bug. Here it is. It's a couple of them. These are actually bugs, though. We've got one that's a ladybug. Brush bot is what I would call them generically, a brush bot. And a bristle bot, that's it, bristle bot. And then we have one that's what kind of bug would this be? I don't know, some sort of true insect, I guess. Maybe a seed bug. Here we have those, the knot. There's a name for this knot. I can't think of it, but that doesn't matter. Little knot, a little toy in a knot. There we go, a couple of those. We have a compressed catnip, other ears on it, which is one I've not seen before. Okay, but wait, there's more. Lindt caramel sea salt, intense orange, and dark chili chocolate. Wow, chili. That sounds pretty cool. All right, so that's Lindt candy bars. Oh my goodness, this basket overflowing with candy now. Oh, and more. Oh wow. Raspberry orange liqueur cookies, Ash Anthonberg since 1884 by appointment to the Royal Danish Court. Well, these better be great. So that's amazing. Chocolate covered marzipan. That sounds so good and it looks so good. Wow. Wow. Where did the list go? Here it is. What does the list have to say? Salted caramel. Okay, marzipan eggs. That's different. Chocolate covered marzipan with a filling of raspberries and orange liqueur. Wow. Three dark chocolate lint bars. Yes. Marzipan eggs. Is that what these are? Yes, that's what it is. It says, what is this word here? It says Fugliog Mad Nougat. We're gonna go with that. I tried my best. These are some big, like marzipan chocolate covered eggs. They look beautiful. I love the pattern on the candy shell too. That's really pretty. Those will be great. Looks like you sent a few of those, although is this a different kind? Certainly a different color. No, I think it's the same stuff though. Beautiful. Oh no, you say pink eggs are chocolate raspberry, the splattered eggs are chocolate and nougat. Wow. Oh my goodness. And 2 packs of cheese dreamies, which at least used to be Ari's favorite thing. I'm not sure if they still are or not, but we will try them on him. You know, cats change their taste sometimes. That is an amazing set of stuff in a wonderful box. Thank you so much. We ran out of room for all of our chocolate in the basket. So, wow, we've got a noisy mom cat in there. She's calling her kids. She does this. She was doing this last night. She calls her kids. She wants the kids to come and, I don't know, nurse or hang out or something. And they've reached the age now where they just ignore her. They're like, "Mom, you're not cool anymore. We don't want to hang out with you." Nibbies, Nibbles, come here. Nibbles. She doesn't know her name either, so that doesn't help. Wow, this is a lot of great stuff. Thank you so much, Jamestown. But the coolest thing you sent is telling us that you're going to be at KACON this year. I'm really looking forward to that. Thank you so much for all of it. I don't know how to organize any of this stuff, but we will get there in due time, I suppose. All right, we'll put that in there. And the rest of this is going to get packed up in the box together at some point. Oh, I want one of these to go upstairs, or maybe both of them. We'll take both. Too useful. All right. This has got to go someplace safe, too. I can't just let you play with the wire by yourself. All right. Moving right along. What is this? GA Girl. Oh, wow. Well, I'm betting this is probably a banana. Let's find out. Hope there's a note. Ooh, in gift wrap, no less. Very fancy. And the note says, "For the new mom cat to put into her endowment, much love from GA Girl." Well, I'm not even going to take it out of the bag then. She can take this whole thing in her endowment. That's super nice. But let's take a look. Let's just see if it's a banana. Oh, I think it is. I think it is. It might be. It could be. It is. A Yao catnip banana. What a great choice. She is going to love that. And you saw already, I'm assuming the new mom cat means Puddles. You saw already how much Puddles loves the catnip that's in her room. So this will be perfect for her to take with her when she goes to her new home. And she can enjoy it there all over again. GA Girl, thank you so much for sending that. Here we go. Let's just put a little bow back on that. I don't think that's going to stay. I should have knotted it first. Hang on. All right, we got this. We can do this. Let's make it look all nice. Puddles is going to really love this. Puddles, I think this is Puddles' first endowment that's specifically for Puddles, isn't it? So that's sweet. Thank you so much, GA Girl. We'll have to start a new box and pile for her downstairs now. Okay. Next up. Hopefully there's a note inside. It doesn't say anything outside. There is a note. Oh, I think I know what this is. I think this is that. Yes, the catnip pineapples for Puddles, because I know she would love it, from Madam Amy Latta. Perfect. So this is the pineapple, and I think she will love it. And I could probably give it to her right meow, although right today she's a little bit distracted. She hasn't wanted to play too much. I don't know. Maybe she will. Anyway, this is for her, so I'm going to set it right there for the moment, and then we'll figure out, do we bring it upstairs now? Do we wait a, a week or two? Do we send it in her endowment? I don't know. Either way, I know she's going to love it. She's obviously a big fan of the catnip toys. So that's perfect for her. This is, all right, very heavy. Let's find out what could be in the heavy box. You think I was calling you Custard? Recycled chewy box. All right. Oh, we've got a knife guard on this one too. Everybody, nobody trusts me with a knife. And the note. Perfect. And wow, this is also packed full. Here we go. Let's see. Dear Mr. A and Dr. DJ, hope all is... There, let me get these dreamies out of the way. Nah, I don't know where to put any of this stuff right now, though. Okay. Hope all's going well at the Academy and with sweet little Teaspoon. He is so cute. In fact, of all the cute utensils, all of the cute utensils are so adorable. I also had a little girl who had a heart condition. She was born with a hole in the bottom chambers of her heart. Even with that, it did not stop her from keeping up with her sisters. I'm sending my usual for all the cute utensils and mini blankets and toys to take to their new forever homes. Please use the treats as you see fit. Thank you for all. Now, that's definitely not for. No, Maggie, you're not going to break that one in. Nope. You come back to this banana. You already had a catnip today. Try this one. There you go. Okay. Thank you for all you do for mom cats and their kittens. Thank you to all the KA community for all the love given to the kittens from Rose, Tucker, Toby, and Tessa. P.S. Give the faculty extra treats and pets from me. Well, of course I will, Rose. Thank you so much. So you send these wonderful little bags, and we'll get to those in just a second. But first off, we have freeze-dried chicken. Great little cat treat for everybody. We have Churu, another great cat treat for everybody. Oh, big jar of Churu. We have an entire stack of Shiba meaty tender sticks. Excellent cat treat. Hi, Ari. You want to try one of these cheese creamies, buddy? You might as well open one of these right now and see how you want it. Ooh, wow, that's got a good smell to it. These look a little different, too. Okay, let me try some. Hang on, Maggie, back up. Here, Maggie, try yours over here. Custard, you want a couple? Okay, go fine. Wow, those are, I wonder if they changed the formula a little bit. They look different than I remember, but they obviously have a wonderful scent, and Ari loves them. Ari's become very picky about treats lately, but he obviously loves them, and so does Maggie, so those are great. Thank you for those. But back to Rose and Rose's box here. Okay, now we have your usual little bags that are full of mice and springs and little fur toys. I see some real fur in there and a cute little cat with an expression on his face, but especially the little flannel blankets with one corner folded over so we can see both sides. Come on now, you kittens. This is a lovely sort of purplish and cyan plaid color with a purple back. For spatula, great choice. We have teaspoons. Teaspoons is this lovely blue that he's gonna look so good on top of. Very photogenic choice. We have goblet with a red, sort of red white plaid and a pink on the inside. Beautiful, the usual toys there. We have spork, gets this blue and red, almost 3D looking. Plaid with a gray interior. I think gray, maybe a little blue, hard to tell. Ramekin has this one, also a blue and red plaid with a gray interior, but a different one. That's for Ramekin. And then finally, we have one here for Nibbles that has a pink and gray with a gray on the bottom. Beautiful. Oh my goodness, they're all so lovely. Thank you so much for those. They are going to love them. Unfortunately, the box is not big enough for me to fit more of their endowments into. So let's see what else we can open here. Rose, thank you very much for that. They're beautiful little gift bags, and I know that their adopters have to appreciate that so much. So, hi, I know you guys are all dreaming of more dreamies now, aren't you? Those things really had a strong smell to them. Just the kind of smell that a cat would like. In fact, this, I'm going to take the piece I tore off the top and put it in my pocket so I can go in the trash can so they don't try to dig it out of these boxes. All right. April in Asheville. All right, April in Asheville. Let's see what we've got here. Ooh, a paper. Oh, no, more candy. I guess Easter is a time when people do chocolate and candy, isn't it? First, the paper. Let's take a look here. Very cool. The Mountain Express.
Press. I have read this before. I'm going to enjoy seeing what's new. And this says, Nerds United, Asheville's comic book scene unmasked. I see what you did there. I like it. We also have the Tribune Papers and, another Mountain Express. Time Travelers, Kids Issue, Part 1. Oh, no, I'll be kept in suspense. Kids Issue, Part 1. All right. Well, that's going to be fun. Thank you so much for that. I'll put that, I'm going to try to put it over here with our stuff. Okay, that's what we'll do. There's a note in here, a couple notes, so let's get to those next. Hello, Mr. A, Dr. DJ, and KA Discorders. Spring has certainly sprung here in Asheville, and it's Easter as well. Our spring hasn't quite sprung yet. The trees are still entirely bare, and it's been pretty cold, but we've just had our first day over 70, so it can't be too much longer now. You say, I'm looking forward to some warm temps, and my cat is loving his evening naps on the porch in the sun. My cat and I are both gingers, so I confess we're smitten with Little Teaspoon, a.k.a. the Golden Child, and check in on him regularly. Can we make it a rule that he has to be adopted with his sister Goblet? She's so sweet and loving with him that I think they would be perfect together. I think all of his sisters are really good to him and would be great for any of them to go together. But, we'll see about it. We won't make it a rule, but I always want people to adopt the cats together. I've included some fun stuff to share with the Academy. There's an envelope for you and Dr. DJ and goodies for everyone. Please use as you see fit. I'm getting a care package together for Puddles, and I'm looking forward to her little squirts arriving safely. I hope everyone enjoys their holiday this weekend and is staying safe and healthy. As always, pet kittens and ramble on. April in Asheville, a.k.a. Ginger Tuffy Cat. And then you have a sticker that says lots of hugs, and you've written for Loganberry. Lots of hugs for Loganberry. That's super sweet. All right. There. Good. Okay. Now, we have notes also. So let's take a look at these notes. This is cute. Mr. A. It's a cat who is carrying an Easter basket full of eggs and wearing rabbit ears. Oh, it says, Happy Easter. Here comes Peter Cattontail. I see. Thank you so much. And you sent a little donation to and a gift card. I'm going to put that right over here so it doesn't get misplaced. Thank you very, very much for that. April in Asheville. Also from Baxter the Dachshund and G the Cat. Maggie, stop eating the treats out of the bag. You can wait. You can hold on there. That's the card. It's super cute. Thank you so much. And the donation is very generous of you. Thank you, April. All right, now Maggie, stop. She's going to eat holes into those greenies. Oh, somebody already did put a little hole in it. Oh, Whiskers from G. Oh, thank you for the Whiskers. And what are these little tiny origami cranes? Maggie, stop. Stop, 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 stop. No, you settle down. These are my treats now. Look at these. And the paper that you've made them out of is super cute, too. Oh, my goodness. Little tiny. Okay, lots of little tiny origami cranes. I see there's a whole handful of them in here. DJ's going to really like that. Thank you so much. I will get that to DJ. Maggie. All right, where's the box for the treats? Here we go. We'll use the beautiful unicorn box. All the treats now have to go in a box. Otherwise, Maggie is going to dig them open. I know those greenies were delicious, but we can't have all of them, all right? Just like the chocolate, we got to pace ourselves at least a little bit. Okay, now hang on. April in Asheville. Wait, there's more. Oh, my goodness. More candy. You've sent a Theo orange dark chocolate. Orange chocolate. That's awesome. Another Walker's shortbread. Wonderful. And a Biscoff. Oh, this is different. Biscoff. With Biscoff cookie butter, it looks like it's a biscuit that's covered in chocolate as opposed to, maybe that's just the picture, though, because it feels like a candy bar that might have bits of Biscoff in it. Hard to say. Either way, that's going to be delicious. Okay. Wow. Our Easter basket is way too full. Thank you, everybody, though, and especially April in Asheville. Much appreciated. Okay. Put that out of the way. What could this be? Well, we don't know. It's a drop shipment. It's come to us straight from China, so I wonder if it will have a note or not. We may end up guessing on this one. Let's find out. Oh, no, I think somebody mentioned this to me in a private message on the Discord today. Look at that. It is a beautiful, giant-sized cow bed. I think it is exactly like the little, tiny cow bed that you've seen the kittens in, but it is huge. Wow. Honestly, I didn't expect it to be quite so big. I don't want to take it out of this bag and not get it back in because it's folded up. But you can see it's just exactly like the little tiny cow bed we have. It even has the ears and the horns in there, and it's shaped the same way. And let me check my Discord because I just saw the message pop up this morning, and I didn't really take a look at it. I think it is from K.A. Bless. Is that right? Maybe. My Discord doesn't want to load. Oh, there we go. It says, good morning, Mr. A. I'm not sure if it will be in this week's mailbag, but a full-size cow bed will be arriving that I couldn't leave a note for. It's for Goblet, inspired by when she was the queen of the tiny cow bed, either for endowment or to be deployed now and go home with her, whichever you see fit. I've gotten to see firsthand how wonderful it is to have some items that the kittens loved from K.A. go home with them. As I type this, Mayhem is curled up on my lap on top of the cow blanket they brought home, and she's licking all the coffee off her tail from when she dipped it in my mug. Mini Spoogles and keep it up and at 'em from K.A. Bless. Thank you so much. Or K.A. Bless, I guess. It's not really K.A. Bless, but, you know, that's what we're going to go with. This is awesome, and it's for Goblet. So I'm going to write Goblet on this plastic. Thank goodness we didn't take it out of there. If I have a pen in here, I'm going to. Yes, we are. Okay. Good. Make sure my brain. You know what? I saw a study. I interrupted myself. Everything got out of order. Now I don't even know where. I just put that piece of paper. All right. Well, this is for Goblet. We know that. Oh, it wasn't a piece of paper. It was on my phone. Oh, my goodness. What the heck? So I was about to say, and I was about to write K.K. Bless on this. This is for Goblet. Goblet. Okay, we'll write that on the other side, too. Anyway, I saw, and I didn't read the paper or anything. I just read the headline. So the worst possible thing you could do, I'm sure it's completely inaccurate, but it did say that they did a study that shows, that sort of illustrates the fact that we, our memories, like we lose things way faster than you would think, or sort of misremember things. Like, you know, we all know that we do that over time, but the study showed that like instantly within 3 seconds, you start to, you forget things or misremember them, under certain circumstances. So, I feel actually like that study was somewhat vindicating. Like, I'm like, oh, thank goodness, I'm not unusual. We all do it. Maybe we just don't all realize it. So anyway, how about that? As I'm trying to explain it, I gave everybody a brilliant demonstration of it. So there we go. All right. K-Bless, thank you so much for all of that. Here we have some lovely receiving blankets that say, welcome to K.A. Puddles. You are such a sweet, beautiful mom. Here are some blankets to help keep your kittens warm from Frozen Tundra Crew. Thank you so much, Frozen Tundra Crew. Seems like you always like to send the blankets for the mom cats. I love this choice. It's very cute pink and reds with hearts and this gray color and the whites. And we've got one with elephants and one with little flowers. Two with little flowers. They're beautiful. Thank you so much. I'll put that with these to go upstairs. Lovely, lovely. We always end up needing more of those as we go through quite a bit. And also when we have adopters that need some spare blankets for their ride, we end up usually giving away some of the used ones of those. That's one of the ways that we end up recycling them a little bit. So thank you so much for those. All right. Now this is, Canada Post. I've covered up the name, so I have no idea. Sure, there's no other clues on the outside, so let's find out. Oh my goodness, carrots. Very cool carrots. All right, let's see. Hang on. There's a note right on top. It says, the note. I love it. J. Walter Weatherman loves it. Wow, it's got a beautiful little painting of three wide-eyed black cats, one apparently adult and two little kittens. Standing in what I think are cherry blossoms and tulips, perhaps? Here we go. You can see. Oh, the artist is Maude Lewis and Canada's most beloved folk artist. It is a beautiful little bit of folk art. It's titled Three Black Cats from 1955, oil on pulp board. Wow, 1955, that's really pretty. Okay, dear Mr. A, Dr. DJ, faculty, mom, cats, and kittens, happy spring, everyone. Thank you for all you do for the mom, cats, and kittens, and for keeping all of us up to date and informed with everything going on at the Academy. I've enclosed some endowments for Nibbles and her cute tinsels. You certainly have, they're so cute. Look at this. They are what appear to be hand-crocheted carrots, and then we also have some mice in here. And the little carrots have the greens on top, and it says Nibbles, Goblet, Spatula, Ramekin, Spork. There's more in here there's a lot more. This box is packed full. Oh, and this one is a special extra box for Teaspoon that has a lamb chops and some extra little toys in it and an extra carrot. How cute. He gets his own. And a special package, you say, for Teaspoon because he is sweet and because he is such a dear. Sorry, because he's such a dear and so special. Other cat toys and treats to be used as you see fit. Receiving blankets to add to your stash and micro mini eggs for you. Also, some cleaning cloths. I managed to make a couple with a pineapple on them. Love and spoogles from Linda, Lola's mom, on Discord. Thank you so much, Linda, Lola's mom. Lola's mom. Okay. Wow. I usually find the handmade cleaning cloths, they're a little too nice to use most of the time. But let's see what we got before we start making judgments about what we can and can't because they're too nice. Maybe they'll be awful, and then I'll feel just great using them. So, all right, here we have a bag of little tiny cat balls and mice that have rattles and bells. We have a grilled chicken filet. Wonderful. And I see some other cat treats here that we should put in the treat box. So there we go. Put those in the treat box. Also, we have some churu to go in the treat box. Wow. 20 tubes. Chicken. Perfect. They are going to love those. Oh, now look at that. I have not seen these before. The Cadbury mini eggs, of course, are my weakness, but these are micro mini eggs, and I can feel in the bag they're much smaller. They're like maybe even pea-sized, much, much smaller than the regular mini eggs. That's interesting. That will, thanks to the square cube law, that is going to throw off the proportion of candy to chocolate. So I wonder how perfect they will be. I guess we'll find out, won't we? Put those right in there. There we go. Here we have a set of Charlie balls, very colorful Charlie balls. Here we have those pith balls that they love to play with. These make great bathtub balls too. We have these weird little toys. I still don't know what to call them after all this time, but they're great cat toys that everybody loves. There's a lot going on there with the ribbons and the little bit of weird string stuff, I don't know, feathers and the little Charlie balls, super colorful, and rattles, all that and a rattle. Okay, those are all great toys, and I'm going to just add them to the pile in front of me of stuff that still needs a box. This can go back here with some box of endowments, perfect. This can go with the box of endowments, excellent. And then we get into, here we go, the receiving blankets. Oh, they have little sheep or lambs on them and some gray and white and yellow. Those are great colors together, by the way. Geometrical patterns. We have some stars and some little triangles and some stripes to go along with the lambs. These are lovely. Thank you so much for those. I'll put those right here as well. And then the handmade pineapple blankets, pineapple washcloths. Oh, this is, I don't know about, I don't see a pineapple in it, but it's got a pineapple texture to it, kind of. It's very sturdy. They're too nice. They're too nice to use. Although these do feel a lot more sturdy than most of the ones that we get, so maybe actually usable. Without me worrying too much about immediately ruining them, which I'm sure I will do. Oh, they're so nice. These are the ones with the pineapple in them. Look at that. That's really cool. You really did get a pineapple in there. I don't know if everybody can see it, but you can see the pineapple here and the little pineapple greens on top. Lovely. And you've sent two of those. These are so nice. Wow. Now, they are too nice to use, but we'll see. Maybe I can get over that. Because that stuff, I don't know, it deserves to be used, right? Anyway, they're beautiful. Thank you so much. I'm going to put those right over here. So thank you very, very much for that. It's Linda, who is Lola's mom. There we go. I got it. Wow. Almost managed to remember that. This box would be really useful for something. Maybe for the as you see fit pile of toys. There we go. All right. Here we go. Right on in there. Right on in there. Maggie, are you getting put in there too? I don't know. Okay. Excellent. Good. Getting a little organized there. Technically, the tree root can go in the treat box, but it's covered, so we're good with that. Ari's on our final box from the Bernadette sisters. I can see that. B&B sisters, I mean. Sorry, Bernadette being one of them. Let's see. So we'll open this first, and then we'll have to disturb Ari. Nothing on the outside here. It just says Kitten Academy. Oh, and inside, just a box. No note. It's not stuck under a flap either. There's just no note. Well, and there's nothing on the box either. It was a big mystery. It's a mystery within a mystery. Oh, it's a carrot. Oh, I think this goes to Madam Amy Lotta then, doesn't it? I think it's a flopping fish, except it's a flopping carrot. Oh, my goodness. What a cute idea. The greens are folded over, but there are even carrot greens on the end. How cute. Here we go. In a little packet of catnip and a charging cable. Okay, that's exactly what it is. It is a flopping carrot. That's a weird choice, but you know, I'm just amazed that no matter what you think of, there is a cat toy of it. So super cute. That's really adorable. I'm going to have to charge that up and get that out here for these kids. I was just looking at our little flopping lobster to see. Maybe I was going to put that out today, but now we have something even more appropriate for the season. And, Madam Amy Lotta says, no, it's not from me. All right. Well, it's a mystery then. We don't know who it is from. We just know you've disavowed it. So who knows? Well, somebody will take credit for it. And whoever it is, thank you in advance. Please let me know. But he's really cute, and I'm sure the kittens are going to love him. It's perfect for Easter. So that leaves us with, I think, just the one box that Ari is sitting on. Ari, buddy. Yep, that's it, pal. The B&B Sisters box. I think we can guess what's in it, though, right? It's going to be some beautiful blankets and all kinds of fun toys. All right, Ari, let's take a look. Okay. Sorry, pal. We got to check it. That's how Mailbag works. You want to get a petting, buddy? Okay, don't tell me about it. Oh. Okay. So, here's our note from the B&B sisters. Let's see what we have to say this week. Aw, cute little happy kitty smelling the flowers, very springtime. And inside it says, Dear Mr. A, Dr. DJ, and all the cats and kittens at the Kitten Academy, spring is our favorite season of the year. So in honor of that, we've sent some spring-themed blankets to be used as you see fit, along with some toys. We've included two cases of Fancy Feast chicken pate, but if you prefer a different brand, please let us know, as we'd like to continue sending food along with the toys and blankets. We keep rooting for Little Teaspoon to grow up big and strong. Thank you for taking such wonderful care of all the mom cats and their precious babies. From the B&B sisters, Beatrice and Bernadette. Thank you so much. So that's really sweet of you. We still have a big stash of Fancy Feast that we are still using. In fact, I gave these kids some last night, I think. So we're kind of working through it for the older cats who process it just fine. But we have been working on switching off of it. And DJ found a cat food that she says she just found it by Googling for like premium cat food. And I guess it was the first thing that came up for her. And she read the ingredients list and the protein content, and we thought, all right, well, it matches everything that we say we require. Plus, the price is almost the same as the Fancy Feast, so it doesn't really put us out anything more. So it seems like a good enough choice, and even better than all of that is that the faculty and the kittens seem to like it. So that really counts for everything. And it's called, it's like I said, I think I said, or was going to say, it gave me a chance to make a bit of a joke. Which I like. I've made the joke too many times now, though, so I have to retire it already. And that is that here at the Kitten, the New Low. It's apparently called New Low Freestyle Grain-Free Turkey and Chicken Recipe. I don't know how long we're going to stick with it, but so far that's what we've done, and we've ordered it a couple times now, so it might be something for us to stick with for a while at least. So Grain-Free Turkey and Chicken Recipe. We also bought their dry food to try out, and there are guidelines right here that show how to feed it for adults and kittens and for nursing moms, although it's really just feed them more, which, you know, of course, that makes sense. It's a pate, so it's just like the texture that these kids are all used to, and it lets me say we've reached a new low here, a new low freestyle. So it's, it's turkey and chicken. And again, I don't know how long we're going to stick with it, but I will be sure to let everybody know if we switch again. But this is what we're trying right now. It actually has a little more protein percentage-wise than the Fancy Feast does. And a list of ingredients that at least sounds a little better. I don't know if that really means anything. But it includes some things like cranberries and pumpkin, which are weird. Tomato, kelp. Tomato, kelp. And yucca. So those are all things that are weird. Like, I don't know that the cats need that, or if they just include that kind of stuff so they can say it's grain-free, yet, you know, it's got pumpkin and yucca in it, which you're like, all right, technically not grains, but if there was anything you didn't like about grains, I'm sure that those would be the same. So, you know, if you're like looking out for the carbs or something, it's exactly the same. So I don't know. But it also says no carrageenan is big on their advertising right here. Contains no carrageenan. And I'm not a nutritionist, so I don't know why people care about it containing carrageenan, but it does contain kelp. So how is that different? Like carrageenan is just seaweed derived from seaweed, right? Oh, we also have a guar gum and agar-agar. So you put that together with the kelp and you're like, all right, it doesn't contain carrageenan by name, but it contains it in everything but name. So it's weird, but those are things I don't care about anyway. I don't care if it contains carrageenan. Why would I? I don't even care if it contains grains as such. I don't know why that matters. I do care about the carb content overall and the protein content overall. And it seems like those are good. So we're happy about that. So this is what we're on right now, a New Low Freestyle. So I'm glad you asked. Gave me a chance to talk about it for the first time, I think. Okay. So you did send some lovely springtime blankets. Some lovely springtime blankets. So this one is a butterfly blanket. It's super cute. Look at these colors, these little pastels and some of these purples and things in here. Really pretty, super soft. Also, we have a yellow, like a canary yellow blanket that's got stars and cat silhouettes on it. Also super soft, of course. And one more here. Oh, wow. This is an abstract sort of a painting of a cat. How beautiful. Look at that. Really pretty. I love those eyes. My goodness, that's a great color in that too. Very spring colors though. So beautiful blankets as always. There we go. And then, like you say, we've got our two cases of Fancy Feast chicken pate in there. Wonderful stuff. It really is. We have cat at Nibbly Grills. These are great treats. Some cats go for them and some don't. We've had some mom cats where it's their favorite thing in the world. So I like to have them around because they're easy to hand out. They don't like get your fingers all messy and they don't make a mess on the bed. They don't make up because they don't have little crunchies, so they don't get little crumbs everywhere. And they're also not like liquids like the Churu is, so you don't have to go wash your hands afterwards. So they're really convenient that way. Let's see here. I'm gonna put that in the treat box. I'm trying to keep the open dreamies on top so that when I put all that away, I can put those in the cabinet. Let's see here. All right, lots of choice. Oh, another one of the fish. All right, I think this fish is so beautiful, but I should tell everybody a story real quick about it. The reason that I've got one out to put around the academy and you don't see it is because Silo grabbed it and chewed a big piece of one of these ribbons off. And it's made out of like a nylon, like a ripstop nylon or something. So it's not technically ripstop nylon. It's some other kind of nylon though. Anyway, it's very, very strong and it's not going to digest. So he ate a giant chunk of it all in one chunk. And DJ saw that it was missing some chunks and saw him chewing on it. So she took it away. And then the next day, thank goodness, he threw up the chunk as one giant piece. But since then, we haven't put it out. Now, it's still a great toy. It's beautiful. It's made out of this rubber and nylon. It lights up. I love the look of it. I love koi. I love the way this thing looks so much. So it's a great toy, but it's kind of toy you got to use supervised, I guess, after all. Most cat toys are like that when it comes down to it. Most toys you're going to want to use only supervised for your cats. So that's good, though. I love it. It's so pretty. I just thought that was a good chance to sort of remind people that you definitely, you want to keep an eye on your cats with their cat toys, because you never know. Okay, Kong Naturals. We got these two little fish with feather tails and fuzzy little sides. Super cute. We have three sort of minnows, like giant minnows with little rattle bells inside. They're really cute. I love the one in the middle, especially. It's got a great sort of old-timey retro feel to it. I guess they all do. Okay, well, these two do. This one looks more realistic, but these two have sort of a, like they belong in one of those old Tom and Jerry cartoons or something, the ones that were real stylized. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going for there, but they're super cute. Okay, we'll put those over in the As You See Fit box. We've got these beautiful fighting fish. Crying out loud. Moving right along. Okay, this is two cute little Easter toys. One says, oh, for peeps' sake, that's cute. And the other one says, Hoppy Easter. Super adorable. Nip chips, catnip flavored potato chips, and with one chip hanging out of the bag. Super cute. What is this one? Oh, it's a crayon box with a bunch of little crayon mice. How cute is that? So we got a crayon box. It's got a face on it. You can't see it. And then these are each, they say crayon on them, and they're patterned like a crayon, except they're mice. That's really cute. Oh my goodness, super cute crayon mice. I love it. Oh, but wait, there's more. There's so much more. Here we have a whole bunch of Charlie balls. These kids love those. Also, the last class, big fan of those. You see them carrying them around all the time. Here we have an odd combination of a sloth and a pineapple wearing glasses. I don't know why, but it says tropical sloth. Okay, I guess that does. It works for me. Tropical sloth. I see how they work. Perfect. Oh, get in the box. All right. Here we have wine and cheese cat toy set, and it is a cheese and a cat Bernay, 1986 vintage cat Bernay. I see what you did there. Very cute. Okay. Here we have, what appears, oh, I get it. I definitely get it. Because what we have here is a car with a license plate that says INSRD. INSRD for the license plate. And over here, we have a little, we'll say salamander. So it's a little salamander, and he's looking at the car, and it says INSRD. That is, that's pretty funny, actually. So I wonder if everybody else gets the joke or if I have to explain it. Probably not, right? It's pretty obvious. Very cute. Okay. Here we have some more of the little beta. Beta is the word I was looking for. See, it came to me. Just took a couple tries. There we go. And the Kong Kickaroo, very cute little tiny cat kicker with the tail on it. Okay. And wait, we're not done yet. We got some eeks. We got this eeky eek mouse. Eek! We got some stripey fish with feather tails in yellow and purple, good colors together. Two more. Oh, a Yao catnip crayons. Excellent. And finally, a box of, well, cat toys, welcome baby, oh, rattle mice. Okay, well, we don't need to open it up from the wonderful packaging quite yet, but it's a whole box full of rattle mice, excellent cat toys. Okay, now we're at the bottom of it, and all that's left are the Fancy Feast, Chicken Feast, Classic Pate, which we will use. We're trying to sort of wean ourselves off of it, but we're not done yet, so that's just fine. B&B Sisters, thank you so much. You take great care of us, and so does everybody else. You guys all come together and take such wonderful care of the Kitten Academy cats. I know the adopters all appreciate it so much. I know today Maggie is really appreciating it, and so is Ari. He's got the dreamies that he's been dreaming of. Perfect for him. All right, but now what I need to do is get up and get all this sorted out and packed away for endowments and various other things. Clean up this mess. The kittens all left and didn't participate at all. It was really a faculty mailbag today, wasn't it? I guess that's okay once in a while, though. They could have participated if they wanted to. And so I am going to do just that. And once we're done, we'll end the archive. And then maybe I'll get some work done today. Maybe I'll just hang out with DJ. It's been a long week for her and kind of a long week for me. I guess the cat delivery counts as something, right? So we'll see. All right. Oh, maybe I can get that microphone working too before next time we need it. Oh, where did this guy come from? Did he come off of one of those packages, or did he fall out loose from a bag and I didn't notice? He's got some cool little feathers on him. Okay, you go over there. And the food to our food store. Let's take these endowments and put them in the big box. That's all of these carrots. Make sure we got that loose carrot label too. Where did that one go? There it is. We got it. Good. Don't want to lose that. Excellent. And then I think we can put the rest of the endowments in the same box. Like so. Nibbles and the kids. Nibbles and the kids. Perfect. That's also for Nibbles and the kids. Now this is also technically an endowment, but not for Nibbles and the kids. It's for the other class. So let's do this. This is the perfect size box for these things. So this is for Puddles specifically. Two catnip toys for a mom that loves the catnip. All right, we can carry that down together. Plus, all of our papers are downstairs, so those can go. Perfect, perfect. Set aside these dreamies for our boy, and then the rest of this can also go in downstairs with their extra treats. Good. So far, so good. The As You See Fit box also going downstairs. You think I can get all this downstairs at once? Well, let's find out. This is it. This is all the stuff that's going down. Oh, and the goblet bed. So close. I really thought we could do this. I'm going to try. I'm going to try anyway. Challenge mode. All right, here we go. Balance is a little bit better. Got it. right. Oh man, so many treats. And this is card for DJ. This should have gone downstairs, that's fine. We can catch up on that. Gotta plug in the electric carrot. That's a good thing to say. Are you meant to get some of that stuff sorted out upstairs? We got it now, though. All right, there we go. Well, thank you so much, everybody, for everything. Especially for the kind words. I really appreciate those. And I know the kittens really appreciate all the stuff and all the treats and all the endowments. Oh, my goodness. They go home with so much, and I do know it's appreciated. So thank you all so much for taking such wonderful care of the kittens. So let's zoom this camera back out before we forget. I think, is it zoomed in? No, it's not zoomed in. Okay, that's at a pretty good angle. We'll just leave it where it is. All right, well, that's it. Thanks again to everybody, and I will see you next time.